Like, give me an average return, would you say, for somebody who has retirement accounts?
Probably 8, 9, 10. I mean, I like to think it's more 14, 15, 16%.
No, most of those numbers are a lie because they don't, the year over year they might be, but if you take it over the span of it,
right,
the span of the, you know, the Great Depression and all this and COVID, you know, you stretch all that out, it's, you know, 8% to 12% is really good. Like, it's really good for those retirement accounts. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So how come Caleb doesn't give any of his money to his retirement or to his stockbroker guy? I only give him my Roth IRAs, but why would I do that? Yeah, because the Roth has a massive tax benefits, I think. So I max out my wife and I max out mine every year. So why would I not give them more?
Well, you're probably getting a better return on your other investments.
There you go. There you go. Yep. I've trained myself to be a better financial advisor than anybody else I could find.
Yep.
Now, there's people that kick my butt all the time. I just don't know those people yet, right?
Oh, yeah.
Right. So, but they get better returns and things like that. But building wealth is you have to teach yourself to be a better financial advisor than places you can park money. Because if you can only make 4% on your money, you should give it to your tax guy. You should give it, I mean, your stock guy or your retirement accounts. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Not bad. It's not bad. You're in the employee mindset. And that'll make sense when you read the cash flow quadrant.
Right.
You've been used to for a very long time earning, exchanging your time for money, even sales. You'll learn in the cash flow quadrant, that's called the self-employed quadrant.
Yeah.
That even in sales, that's still on the other side of the quadrant of where you want to be. You want to be on the business owner and the investor and things like that.
Yep.
The reason, okay, I'm going to be really blunt. Hang in there for me, okay?
Yeah,
the reason money has not showed up and stayed in your life is because you're putting faith in it, that you're going to have security when you have more money. And I'll prove to you that I'm right by this. I want you to set a checking account balance in your bank.
Uh-huh.
Okay. What would be a lot, would you say, to have in one of your checking accounts at the bank? What would be a lot? Give me a number.
Oh, gosh. This is funny. I'd say 20,000.
Okay. So you got 20,000. Okay. So I want you to just remember that. You told me 20,000. Okay.
Yep.
And over however long it takes you, I want you to get $20,000 in your bank.
Yep.
Okay. And then I want you to tell me how you feel after you've had $20,000 in their bank for a while. I want you to tell me how you feel when it goes down to 15
right.
or 12 or 9. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to go at that point, you're going to go, well, my security's all gone. I got to build it back up to 20.
Right.
And the truth of it is that as long as you put faith and security inside of money, it's never going to show up for you. So we really got to work on detaching. You're not going to be any happier. I hate to break it to you. It's going to be easier. You're going to have more choices and more options. You worry about all sorts of different things than the next level that you bump up to. Because there's going to be a time when you have 200 grand in there and you'll go, well, I'm worried about this and I've got that investment over there and I got this, you know what I mean? You're always going to have it. So we really got to work on detaching the emotion from the money inside of your mind, and it will accelerate you to build wealth at a rapid high level. But wealth will show up when you let it go. When you let money go, like people try to hold on to their money like this.
Right.
And they choke the life out of it. It never gets a return.
Yeah.
It's our human nature because we want to hold on to it because we're worried it's going to go away. It's going to disappear and we're never going to see it again. And we work so hard for it. And now the agents all are calling me and they're driving me nuts. And I work so hard for it and I got it and I'm not letting it go.
Yeah. I mean, I would freak out when, you know, it was like, because I never knew when the next one was going to come.
Yep. And we hold on to it. And it's okay. But what we need to do is we need to train our brain and our emotions to go, I got this money in my hand. What's the best thing I should do with it? Because it's just mine for a little while. When I die, I'm not taking it with me. What am I going to do with it? What am I going to do with it while it's here? And you just let it go. And you let it go and go, all right, there it is. Great. I got 20 grand in my bank account. What should I do with it? Where should I invest it? You know what I mean? Like, we need to like have that type of attitude with it. That's all wealth building is being able to control your fear and act with logic in and around your investments. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
The cool thing is you're part of a group that there's probably 15 millionaires that you probably already know in our world over here.
Wow.
What do they call the really rich? What do they call them? They're called the 1%. Okay. Here's another thing that you should start carrying around with you. That means that 99% of the people that want to give you money advice, you should not listen to. Let's just go 80-20. Let's just do the 80-20 Pareto's law. That means is the wealthy 20%. That means that 80% of the people that you know, you should not listen to about finance.
I agree with you wholeheartedly on that one.
If you're going to stay in the employee category, and it'll make sense when you read cash flow quadrant, if you're going to stay in the employee category, the way that you get to where your money works for itself is you have to save. Like, it's the only way. You have to save, and then invest it into a retirement account and get it to earn and compound and things like that. Oh, becoming wealthy is owning assets, period.
Right.
Period. And what's an asset? Market centers are assets. Stocks in companies are assets. Well, that might be your thing too. You know what I mean? Mine's flipping real estate and buying real estate and commercial and things like that. But your thing might be stocks. It could be. The difference is you got to be able to take some of your money, let it go, and say, I need you to go make more money.
You know, you don't know what the map looks like. So it doesn't seem, you know, it's like you don't know what you don't know. You know, yeah. It's like,
how do I do that now?
How do I do that?
Let's segue into our next conversation, okay? So in order to ever accomplish an income goal, right, or a passive income goal or any of that things, you have to start with a certain number. I'm going to show you that this is actually super easy. But here's the thing. I'm going to show you where the gym is. I'm going to show you the routine, the workout routine you got to do. And then you got to go put in the time. Like that's like the most frustrating, like seriously, the most frustrating thing about when I wealth coach with people is that I can't, I'm like, just get out of my way. I'll do it. Like, you know what I mean? Like just because I know that if I do it, it'll work. But I can't do that. You can't do that for everybody. It's like, you have to do it. I'll point you in the right direction and you got to run with it. Yep.
I am entrepreneurial and that I like to think of ideas and different things and all that stuff. But if I have a roadmap and if somebody says, I guarantee you, if you do all this,
yeah.
To get you here.
Yep.
I mean, that's a no-brainer to me.
Perfect. I'm just going to name some habits of things that you have to do on your own. Mm-hmm. That like you either do it or you don't. Like read Rich Dad Poor Dad, read Cash Flow Quadrant. You have to start to save. Like, I don't care how much money you make, you need to save money.
Yep.
I don't care what it is, your savings account has to grow, and that'll never change. To this day, just until last year, I was saving in the 90%. I was like that extreme about it because I wanted to grow wealth. So that way, when I was young with my kids, I wanted to spend time with them. So I knew I'm like, I basically said I have my 20s.
Right.
So I'm like, I save 95% of it to reinvest it. So that way now, like, you know, when I go up north with my kids, like I can do that.
Right.
Like I wanted that freedom. So, but I had to save. Okay. So like you, that's another habit should be on your list. That's just like, okay, how much might I save today? How much should I save it? You all the time say you're very conservative with your money. That's great. You're also opening your arms up and introducing a lot more assets into your life.
Mm-hmm.
You need to go, you remember your brain needs to get on the track of that. You don't work, you build. You don't work to earn money anymore. You build wealth at this point. What else do you need?